What is going on, guys? B-Dog743 here. Back again for another American Truck Simulator episode here. We're here with Mrs. B-Dog and Little B-Dog, a.k.a. Bumble. My wife is making fun of me on how I do my intros. She doesn't understand why I say, what is up? She's like, why don't you just say, what's up? And then she went on rambling on about this whole Papa Goldie Bear, Lock. Mama Bear, Goldilocks Bear, whatever. I don't know. So, a little bit of an update here, guys. We did a lot. I did a lot of work off camera. I wanted to kind of further progress. I wanted to reach level 10. Okay, that was my main thing. I wanted to reach level 10, and it was a long haul to do so. It was mainly just a lot of driving and a lot of back and forth doing loads, this and that. So, and, you know, it would have been a lot of episodes, but I wanted to at least reach level 10. That way, so we can move on and get going on our next step or our next chapter in this video game. And right now I'm talking with my hands, and my wife's literally making fun of me sitting here doing the hand gestures with me because she thinks she is so funny. So, yeah, we actually did a little bit of upgrading to the truck here. We got more lights. We also put a bigger engine on it. Finally unlocked the sleeper cab, and you know we had to get a bigger chassis as well to do so. So we are definitely running a 220 gallon tank. Went ahead and got the cool little side skirts in the back here. Looks pretty neat, but I think we're gonna be joining the dark side, guys. That's right. It's time to build up our company here. It's time to pass this truck on down and, you know, really advance on our company here. So we get a driver in this truck making us money as well while we're on our way to, you know, doing other loads. So probably going to, you know, not trade this truck in, but we're probably going to take out another loan. We're going to go to the dark side here. Let's do a little bit of Peterbilt action here, see what they're all about in this game as well. I mean, I guess they got some of the look as the Kenworths do. I don't know. I'm still just a big Kenworth guy. I love Kenworth trucks. So, yeah. So, right off the bat here, we do need to go in. Oh, and by the way, we did pay off our bank loan here. So, if we go over yonder to the bank here, I paid off my loan. So, it's going to hurt, but we're going to have to do a $400,000 loan. Ugh, I know. And, it's all right. So, we got a little over 439,000, pretty good, right? And I do know that the first thing that we're going to need to do is we need to upgrade our garage because we can only hold one truck in this tiny little garage here. So right off the bat, we're going to have to blow 180 grand on the new garage here. And, of course, it's going to go through its little cutscene here, showing us all the new gadgets and gizmos of the new garage. Oh yeah, and hopefully it doesn't kick us out of the Peterbilt dealership where we were at. I mean, if not, we can just drive straight down the road. So check it out, guys. Here is our upgraded building. We have three garage ports here. We got a whole bunch of cool stuff going on inside. We'll actually take a look around inside. Yeah. So, we've got, cool, so we can have a total of three drivers now. We're only going to be able to do one, so without further ado, guys, let's actually mosey our way into the Peterbilt building here, and let's join the dark side, and let's see what they got to offer us here. We're going to miss this truck. I mean, it'll still be with us, but truck dealer's closed! No! Oh, they open at 8. That's next morning. Uh-oh. Okay, well, fair enough. We'll just sleep then. I don't care. We'll sleep. We'll do it.
We'll do it.
He covers his nose when he sleeps. Sneeps. Sneezes. Sneeps. Okay, so we do need to pull up in here. It's kind of funny that we can just sleep right here next to the service entrance. Don't mind him, guys. Sorry about that. He's just super happy, and he's playing around. And Bumble. Set it open up at 8, so we'll rest again. Don't sleep all day. Okay, cool. All right. So, got our parking brake on. We got to disengage our parking brake here. Do a nice little reverse action here. Definitely was nice having that engine upgrade. It was totally worth it. I mean, it was expensive, though. So, yes. So I did vamp up my brightness just a little bit and turn up my refresh rate. Did notice some, you know, some of my videos, it did look a little dark. So, you know, once again, it's no big deal. But, all right. Without further ado here, let's hop into the Peterbilt truck dealership here. So we have $259,000 to spend here. I don't know what it is. I like. It's 153. So these are just added on like sleepers, I guess. And yeah. So I think we're actually gonna go with this guy here. He's $125,000. Let's go ahead and get him a little bit customized here and see what we can get. So we can, of course, we can get the low roof sleeper. Yeah, we'll remove it. Don't worry. So automatically that brings our total up to $145,000, but it's great to have a sleeper on there, which is no big deal. So the chassis, we are running a 220-gallon, which is good. We'll throw the bigger engine in there. So it bumps us up to $148,000. And we'll also get the fuller 18-speed here. Totally decking this guy out here. Let's get the Alter Red. I like that wooden interior there. Looks good. Let's divide it. Ooh. Yeah. You know what? We're going for a custom metallic here. It's going to cost us a pretty penny. Let's see what we could do here. Let's do a red. Fade to black. And we'll move this over here a little bit. White. Yeah, we'll leave it white. Oh, that's pretty. I like that. It's a good looking truck there. All right, so let's see what else we can do here. We'll definitely go with, I like the painted mirrors, that's nice. Let's get, what's the difference? No. Believe it or not, I actually like the newer style lights. We'll get the modern flares here. I know, like, God, B-Dog, you're going so expensive. But, you know, this is going to be our new truck, guys, and I want it to look good. The standard sun shield here, I like the painted one. Looks good. We will do... So what do we have on here? We have the Lumen Mark 1s. The Lumen Mark 2. Is that the same one? Are these the same ones here? No, they're not. So we'll change out these two. Because otherwise it's going to bug me. I want to have all kind of one style light here. We'll try out these Lumen Mark 2s here. Kind of like that streamlined look. Throw our horns on here. Ooh, look at that. Super Roar. Yeah, we'll do the Super Roars. So we are dumping a pretty penny in this guy here, but it is our truck, and we're going to be stuck with this. I mean, not really stuck with it, but we are going to be in this truck for a while. And chrome painted. I like the painted ones. Look good. All right, chrome air filters, exclusive or basic? Let's do the exclusives. I like the gray, and it has like the nice red bands here. Oh, yeah, I'm really digging this truck so far. And throw a side mirror on there. Let's get all the bells and whistles, huh? So definitely we'll have a little bit more access to more things as we, you know, we level up further. Painted door handle? Nah. We'll leave it chrome. You know, we're spending way more money than whatnot here. Ooh. Ooh. No, I like the lights. Going with the lights. Yes. What's this? Can we change the stacks on it? I wish we could change the stacks, too. I kind of like those stacks. They look kind of neat, cool. We'll do this, of course, that's the only option we have anyways. Standard mug guards. We'll do the... Is it hot rods? Do the progress. I like that little bit darker color. Progress. Rear tires. We'll do the Roadmasters. Boy, oh boy, this is one expensive truck here. Look at that, we got like an invisible option. That's kind of goofy. And we'll do the Progress ones as well. Or should we do the Hot Rod Special with Drum? No, we should keep it relatively the same. Alright, so there's that. And we can... And we'll throw a little pizzazz on there with the white. Got going on here. Okay, so that handles that. Interior accessories. Is that sun visor? Yeah. Real exclusive. Oh, right here. Ooh, yeah. Look at that. What's this? Oh, we can add a knob too. Yeah. We'll put a wood knob just to seal the deal here. No. Chrome. No. No. Yeah, you know what? No. No, no, no. I don't want it. Exit. What's this? It's air filters. Our air filters. That is our mirrors. Gosh, this is a pretty truck. Look at that sleeper back there. Beautiful. All right. Well, there it is. We got our brand new Peterbilt truck here. We'll do a, what is it? Nope. Do camera. Take a picture. Looks good. Yeah. All right. So without further ado, guys, it's going to hurt the wallet. Ooh. We'll confirm it here. And we will purchase. Drive our new truck, yes. We'll have it here. Send it to our garage. Oh wait, nope. Oh, yep. Whatever. Put it there. Thank you for your new purchase. Enjoy your new truck. We will take your old one to your garage in San Diego right away. Please note, all trucks bought here have regular insurance paid already. Cool. All right. Look at this. Yeah, that's a pretty truck. I can dig the Peterbilt. I do like it. It looks good. Still a big Kenworth guy though. Still Kenworth guy all the way. But I like this. It looks good. That's gonna bug me. We're gonna have to change one of the lights. One of the lights on top's is not the same. Dang it. All right, here it is, guys. Wow. Yeah, that's pretty. I like the headlights on it. I really do like those. So if you didn't notice, I do need to fix one of the lights on here. It's going to bug me if I don't. It's like $200. Don't worry about it. All right. Need to upgrade. Accessories. It is this one. Yes. Mark II. There we go. $92. Worth it rather than looking like a goofball. There we go. Now all of our lights are the same. I like those lights. Those lights look good. So yeah, right on. We got a little side mirror here as well. Wow. Pretty looking truck. Alright, 1 second, guys. We'll be right back. All right, sorry about that. So, yeah, look at that. Pretty looking truck. Cool. Oh, and right off the bat here, I did want to let you guys know, I only put three of the skills here into the long distance because that is, like, the maximum drive, I think. I mean, I could probably put more just to max it out, you know. But we did unlock the flammable hazmat or hazardous cargo as well as another slot in our high-value cargo and fuel economy. So we're not doing too bad. We do need to go to our recruitment agency here. We have $83,000 left over. We're doing well. We are doing pretty good for ourselves. So we need to go to our driver manager. Recruitment agency. Yeah, okay. So San Diego. Let's hire a driver. Okay. So, kind of looking for someone. Let's check out here in Bakersfield. Okay. Well, so right off the bat here, George W. seems like our best candidate here because, you know, he's got a hazardous cargo. He's also got two long-distance checks here. The other guy has, I mean, he has one for the high value and then one for just-in-time and fuel economy, and this guy only has two, which is one for just-in-time and one for fuel economy. So we're honestly going to go with George W. here. We're going to put him in our Kenworth. All right, he'll arrive shortly after they get settled, and he will start working automatically, providing that they have a truck to drive. So he's got his very own truck. So he'll be good to go. And we can start on our very own loads that we need to do here. So we go to map. Check out the freight market here. See what we got. So, hey guys, you know, I'm sorry that, you know, you guys didn't really get to see some of the, you know, the long-term gameplay that we were doing here. I didn't buy really anything until, you know, I at least hit level 10 and I got all the day cab and all that fun stuff. And I took her Kenworth on a few loads. And then I was like, well, you know what? We really need to get another truck. And, I can't just, like, let the new guy drive the brand new truck, so that's why, we still kept it. But, yeah, we will take, let's take a digger. We'll take a, well, need to find something out of San Diego first. let's see here. Got another digger here going all the way up to Truckee. Or should we take tires? They're almost the same distance. You know what? Let's go for it. Let's pick this tire load up here. Yeah, I can dig this truck. I like it. And you best be darn tootin', and then we'll be picking up another Kenworth. All right. So yeah, from this point out, definitely, the gameplay will be, I won't be really much doing much else off camera. You know, it's just that whenever I record and I'm like, I don't really want to stop playing. I want to kind of keep going. You know, because I like this game. It looks, you know, I really like playing this game, too. You know, I've got Farming Simulator and stuff like that I got to worry about. So, you know, it's definitely kind of a toss-up between the two, doing them, you know, as much as I can. And, you know, providing, you know, I have the time to do them. Say that horn. Ooh. It's a nice sounding horn there. Horn sounds like it's got a set of cojones under it on that one. So yeah, it looks like this load will be our one load. We're going to probably only be able to do this load, and we're still probably going to run a little bit long on the video. It's no big deal. So yeah. Don't you dare. No. It's my light. I go. Alright, we're stopping in this Volson Motors here. Tune this guy down here a little bit. So our guy's pretty well rested here. He's good to go. Shoot, did we just miss it? No, that's it right there. That was worth more. Alright. So our trailer is ready. Whoa! Sorry about that. So our trailer's ready for pickup here. We're gonna pick this guy up, this cool cat up here. I should probably honestly come in the other way. That way so it's not a big pain in the rear end to pull out of here. Bear with me. Sorry, I can't really see. I'll have to check to make sure that my mod's still enabled for that change in camera view here. Alright, so we got our tire load here. We are onward on this long haul, this long journey that we get to take together. So buckle up, guys, and we've already... What did we smash into? What? Not even close. Oh, this is gonna be fun. Well, excuse you, they're burping on film. Right, there we go. Cleared it.
I'm gonna walk down to the next to get buns for dinner.
Okay, what do we have? Sloppy Joe's?
Yes.
Okay.
What do you want?
I don't know. I almost want to say Chinese, but...
We're not buying any more food.
I know.
Dang it. We'll go out one on the weekend.
Oh, I'm not going to make it. I think Bumble farted. Whew, dang, dog. Got a stinky butt. Oh, we're almost kissing that wall. Ooh. There we go. I'm sure those cars are like, what the heck are you doing, man? Alright. What do you think of the truck, dear?
Large.
Yep, large and in charge indeed. Really? Wow. Holy cow!
It's just a bird.
Dang!
Sorry.
That's the thing about my wife. She just loud and proud. Awesome.
I'm not like gross though.
Ow. No, you're not. You're good. I'm just joshing you, dear.
I'm ladylike.
Ladylike.
Come on, Bumble.
Alright, you taking him with you?
No, I'm gonna lock him.
Oh.
Because I don't think he'll make it down to the store.
No, let's not smack him in the car. Oh, we smacked him in the car. Oh, we didn't get a ticket for it. Run away. Oops. Nobody saw that, did you? That's a crappy little horn. How could a big truck have a horn like that? I mean, I understand it's just like the, you know, not your air horns or anything. Oh man, we really need to slow down here. Sorry about that. I'm used to playing Farm Sim right now. Oh man, this trailer is long. That is definitely a long trailer. It definitely provides for a little bit of not much wiggle room. That even makes sense. Hey, that guy's copying our truck. Not cool, man. My truck's prettier, though. So, yeah. Onward to victory, guys. Leave this on here. So they need it by Wednesday by 10 o'clock in the morning. Ooh, that's going to be a little rough. So we got 30. Don't have to rest for another 13 hours. Doing pretty good here. And we're going to make it in 13 hours. So we might actually be doing pretty good. There we go. So yeah, it says that we don't need to rest for 13 hours, 29 minutes, and we're going to get there by 13 hours and 18 minutes. So we're going to be good. We're going to be able to solo drive this without having to take a sleepy time. Hey, is that my truck? That's my truck. Is it? No. There's no way. No, it's not. Never mind. Sorry. Got all excited. I'm like, really? That's cool. All right. So we've joined the Peterbilt family. We've added it to our Kenworth family here. So far, yeah. I mean, it's a good truck. I like it. Definitely costed us a pretty penny, and we owe the bank a lot of money, but we'll work on it over time to pay back their loan. Alright, so we're going to be hopping on the highway here. We're hopping on the good old 5 North. Alright, so we got the 18 speed in here, with the 470 horsepower engine as well, or 450 I think it is, I don't know, can't remember what we put in there, my memory goes so bad. So yeah, it's cruising on down the road. Set our cruise control at 57 miles an hour because they give us a little bit of wiggle room here. Yeah, I like the wooden interior with the wooden steering wheel. Love it. So overall, yeah, man, not a bad truck. And we'll just use our little in dash there. I need to pay attention to the road, not to that. Alright. So yeah, our fuel should, you know, kind of go down a little bit more slowly since we got a little couple checks in our box for the fuel economy. As well as we got the bigger tank. But it will cost us more to refuel, which is fine. This means we're not going to have to refuel as much. Yeah, guys, we're on the road. getting a screenshot for this guy here. Pretty. Alright, we'll pull up our stuff here again. Alright. 12 hours and 6 minutes here for the time that we need to rest, and we'll be there in 11 hours and 27 minutes. Perfect. You're pulling in a nice, cool $10,800. Running 42,000 pounds of cargo here. It's going to San Rafael Sunshine Crops. Probably just turn on our lights here. So I wish the trailer lights were a little bit more illuminated, you know, kind of like this, you know, the truck lights a little bit. Ah, that is a pretty looking truck though. Oop, sorry car. Oh yeah, we're doing just fine. I like the separate windows and the window separator there in the middle. It's kind of neat. Field of view in this truck isn't that bad at all. Not to mention we have a sleeper. I don't know if that means we could sleep anywhere if we need to. If we could just pull over on the side of the road, on the side of the road. I don't know. Maybe. If that's what that means. Or if we still have to pull in like the designated sleeping areas. I don't know. So yeah, guess we're having Sloppy Joe's for dinner tonight. Get my tattoo this Saturday. This dude better not cancel on me this time or else I'm gonna be really bummed again. So I'm so excited to get this tattoo. I'm so ready to get it. Been waiting for a while. Been talking about doing it for a little over 9 months now. Just haven't really had the time nor the money. But it's a Christmas present from my wife, so at least getting half my sleeve started. Trying out this new drink too. It's called Mutant Super Soda from Monster. It's pretty good. I don't normally drink Monsters, but this is more of like a carbonated soda version. It's not as intense, I guess, as the your regular Monsters. Regular Monsters give me like a, I don't want to say like heartburn, but like acid reflux, and it kind of makes my stomach hurt a little bit. I used to drink them all the time, but can't really do that anymore. Plus, they're not good for you at all. Yeah, I turned on my game brightness just a little bit. Hopefully, that kind of helps out on video. Videos are looking a little bit dark again on my video editing software. Once they come out of the video editing software, so I got to take a little bit further look into that. Kind of see what's going on. So just cruising along. Wonder how our driver's doing. Wonder if he's on his first load or not per our company. Dang it. Gotta pull in for a wait stop here. Gonna slow our progress down, darn wait stations. Boy, listen to that. Listen to that brake, engine brake there. Thank you so much. 76,736 pounds. That's a lot of weight. But old Betsy here can handle it. Yeah, that guy's actually checked this time. Checked my blind spot. Now we gotta build up speed again. Dang it. It's the worst when you gotta sit here and build up speed. And it's great once you have your speed set and you're just at your cruise control, you're just steering away. Well, it doesn't work like that all the time, I guess. So definitely we're gonna have to make sure that we're doing decent sized loads, you know, more long hauls, because the, you know, the loan that we have taken out, you know, it's gonna be costing us around $5,000 a day. So, you know, and on top of that you have your gas, you know, sure, our, you know, hired worker's gonna be costing us a penny here. Oh, I'm not paying attention to our speed. Oops. I'll do 58. There we go. All right, back up to speed. Perfect. Let's see here. We are 6 hours and 10 minutes away. We need to rest in 8 hours. Doing pretty good. Doing pretty good indeed. Got another copper up there. Sneaky, sneaky state trooper there. Wish the highway speeds were a little bit greater here. I mean, I wish they were like 75. That'd be nice. Maybe even, you know, 65. For trucks, at least. But I guess that's just the way the cookie crumbles here. Alright, passing up Fresno. Santa Cruz over there to our left. Not bad. 1% damage to the truck. When I hit. Oh, that's when I smacked into that car. Dang it. Or it might be the tires. I don't know. Wear on the tires. That wouldn't make sense if it happened already. Alright. So we got 12 hours remaining in the job here. We'll make it plenty of time. So yeah, it's going to be a little bit longer episode. It's already running on here, almost a 40 minutes long. No big deal here. I'm cool with making longer episodes. So yeah, I hope you guys are enjoying the series here. Got a lot more stuff coming out and stuff brewing in the video editor. So, hope you guys are definitely enjoying it. I am enjoying playing this game. I am enjoying playing Farming Simulator. So, yeah. So unfortunately, I did have to shave my face today because I had to go in, you know, Navy PT gear, so technically being in a uniform. So I had to shave, and that's depressing because I was really enjoying the facial hair that was on my smug face here. It's a shame to see it go, but that's life. Get out of my way, slowpokes. Got places to be, things to do. There's a good old Kenworth right there. Kinda miss my truck, but it is what it is. Flashed him a little thank you there for letting me over. Alright. Income $444. Way to go, George. I think that's what we paid him. I don't know. It will be there in 2 hours. Oh my gosh, we're getting close. A lot of time here until we have to take a rest. Cool with me. Popping off here. Slow down here. Alright. Alright. Bit out in the lane here. Oops. This game would be really awesome with some track IR. Recruitment agency, cool. Alright. Yeah, we're coming up close. We're going to be hopping on another highway here, it looks like. Another interstate. Wish everything kind of connected together rather than cutting certain roads off, but you got to live with it, I guess. Kind of a bummer. Stop before I get a frickin' ticket. Sorry. No, don't use your parking brake to slam on your brakes, you know. Just not really kill your truck there. Alright. So, again with the 55. Can we please jump up to 65? So we're 75 miles away, aka an hour and 50 minutes almost out. And we don't have to sleep for another 4 hours. We are so good. It's a nice long haul. It's going to bring us in a pretty little nice bit of cash. It's a lot of, you know, it's a lot of money, $10,000, so it's cool. Really cool. Oops. Stay in your lane there, B-Dog. Turn that guy off for a little bit. 57. Cool. So then set our cruise control there. 2 miles out. 2 miles an hour over the speed limit. Not bad. Alright. up there, Mr. Popo? Is that a toll? Oh no. Gotta get over. Oh, it's my first time seeing a toll in this game. Pick a lane, B-Dog. $25? Hey, that's a hefty toll. Good lord. Oh well. Cool. That's pretty sweet. Yeah, you go ahead and go, Mr. Officer. Speedy Gonzalez there. Alright. For an hour and 8 minutes away. Across this big old bridge here. Nice looking bridge, too. Cool. Oh, stay in your lane. Alright. So continuing on the 580 north here. Oh yeah, that's going to give us a nice little speed boost right here. Yeah! Set our cruise control 57 miles an hour. Looking pretty good on gas here. Almost about half tank, I think. A little over half. Oh no, we missed our stop. Shoot. Uh-oh. Hopefully that's not gonna screw us. Oh no, that's okay. We're good. We'll just have to get off at the next exit. Woo! Got scared there for a second. too busy paying attention to something else. Little California roll there. A light one. Alright, we are in San Rafael. We did it. Yep, thanks. I'm turning right. Better not ding me. Alright, we got a fuel station right over here. A place to sleep over here. San Rafael discovered. Cool. Got a bar. Oh yeah, let's celebrate. Celebrate our company's success so far. Alright, here's our turn in right here. Alright, your load's here, guys. 2 o'clock in the morning, almost 3 o'clock. Handle job delivery. Where do you need it? Where? Alright, not bad at all. Should be good. So I'm gonna definitely start cutting it over here. Oh, this is easy. Psh. Pull up a little bit more here. We'll just back straight up. Quite literally. Come on, trailer. Straighten out now. Oop, oop. I could really fudge this up too, huh? Go nice and steady pace here. Oop. Bring it back around. Bring it back around. Fool. No, 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 no. Dang it. Yeah, leave it to me to fudge things up. I'm gonna try to mumble while I'm watching my other mirror here. There we go. So we'll start straightening her out a little bit here. Nice and easy does it. I'll call it good. Lower down our trailer here. Unhook. There we go. Job completed. Tires delivered from San Diego to San Rafael. It was a 525-mile drive. Pretty long drive. Time taken. It took us 10 hours, 51 minutes. That's pretty good. All right. So we got $10,860, and we got 828 experience. Almost to level 11. Just over a halfway mark. So, cool. All right, guys. Well, thank you guys so much once again for watching. I'm B-Dog. This is our American Truck Simulator series here. Once again, you guys are awesome. Thank you guys so much for watching and hanging out here. Please throw me a like, subscribe if you haven't already subscribed. That'd be awesome. I make content every day. I release videos every day. I try to stick to two a day. One farming sim, one of this. And if we play Arma 2, I try to release an Arma 1. Haven't really played Arma a whole lot lately. Just been kind of wrapped up in Farm Sim and American Truck Sim here. So yeah, guys, thank you so much for joining me on this awesome series here. Throw me a like, a comment as well if you tell me how your life's going or tell me how I'm doing or... yeah, so right on, guys. I'm B-Dog. Thank you so much for watching. Catch you in the next episode.